Hi guys, my name's Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. Today we're having a look at this fella. This is the Suhr Eclipse, and it's a two-stage amp in a box pedal. It's really rather cool. What you get is essentially two pedals that are absolutely identical in a single box. We'll get onto that in a moment. Each side has its own foot switch, gain, level, three-band EQ, and there's a shared voice control that we'll get onto in just a moment. Now, as I mentioned, both sides of this pedal are absolutely identical. So if we set them to have the same settings, I'm gonna get as close as I can. I'm just gonna eyeball it. We'll get everything at 12 o'clock, including that voice control. What we should get is essentially the same sound from both. Now, I don't know if I've got these just right, but we'll sharp find out. For this demo, by the way, I'm using my Paul Reed Smith Custom 22 with hand-wound high-output Bulldog humbuckers. This is a black label, and that's an Extremist. And we're using a Matamp GT20 set completely clean. The Matamp sounds like this. Here's the bridge pickup. And here's the neck pickup. So, with this pedal set, with both sides exactly the same, here is the blue channel. And the red channel, which should sound exactly the same. Now, any variance in tone there is down to me not quite getting the knobs in the right place. The two sides, you'll have to trust me on this, are absolutely mirror images of each other. So from now on, what I'm going to do is I'm going to reset the red side to roughly where I like it. We'll come back to that in a second. And we'll make all of our alterations to the blue side. Now you may be wondering why you would want two pedals that are exactly the same. Well, essentially what you get is, it's a bit like having a three-channel amp in a box. You turn it off and you've got your clean tone. You can have a rhythm tone set up on the blue side, and you can move to a high-gain saturated lead tone on the red side, or you could do it the other way around if you prefer. Completely up to you, they're both exactly the same. You could even have exactly the same tone if you wanted, but you could have one side louder than another, if that's your thing. That's kind of cool. And because we have a three-band EQ for each side, you can tailor both of these tones exactly to your heart's content. So I'm gonna get that voice control again around 12 o'clock. Let's start with the blue side. We're gonna have the gain, all of the EQs, and the voice control around 12 o'clock, and I will just set the level to taste. So once again, as a reminder, here's a clean sound. We're on the bridge humbucker. And on the blue channel. Now as you bring the level up, you can hear this level can go way, way past unity gain. It starts to get really loud. If I go any further than that, it's gonna clip the microphone. So you can use this to drive the front end of a distorted amplifier if you like, although I would argue that's probably not the intended purpose of a pedal like this. Let's get it back around unity and we'll explore the range of gain that's available. So once again, bridge humbucker. This is the gain set about 9 o'clock. If we turn it up 12 o'clock, we get a little more filth. And even though we're not using a huge amount of gain by this point, there's a really pleasing compression to the sound. If you're into your rock or your kind of like 80s shreddy stuff like I am, it feels great to play, even though there's not a huge amount of saturation going on. Thus far. However, if we push it further, we can really start to get some filth happening. This is about the 3 o'clock position. Maybe it's about 2/3 of the way up. And already you can hear the low end warmth is starting to appear, that big cabinet woof. We are miking up a Marshall 4x12, so there's quite a lot of kind of guts behind this. But even still, let's try it one more time. And let's go all the way, why not? So there are absolutely preposterous amounts of gain on tap. Now, if you have a guitar with very, very hot pickups like mine, you might not need that much, but for argument's sake, if we were to tap the bridge pickup and simulate having perhaps a Strat bridge pickup or a Tele bridge pickup, something a little less hot, here is the full fat version. And here it is tapped. So you can hear right away that's a little bit lower output. Perhaps weaker is not the word, but certainly there's less coming out of the pickup. You can make use of this extended gain range to bring that pickup into proper screaming territory. So there's a whole ton of gain on tap to suit whatever guitar you're using. Now, the really cool thing about this is if you like the rhythm sound, like I do, with the gain fairly low, and you enjoy a kind of high gain screaming lead sound, you can get both of these from this pedal without having to sacrifice one tone for another or without having to bend down and fiddle with the pots at all. Let's talk for a moment about the voice control. Now, the voice control is a really cool feature that's been cropping up in a lot of amp-in-a-box type pedals lately. What it essentially is for is tailoring the response of your pedal to your amplifier. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make some slight tweaks to the amp, which we have down here, bear with me. I'm gonna turn up the attack control very, very high on my GT20. Now, for those of you who don't know what this is, go to the Matamp website, look up the GT20. It basically has a negative feedback control. When you turn it all the way up, the amp gets very bright and very fast and quite spiky almost is not the word because it never really goes that far, but it's certainly very spanky. Here it is with the attack control turned all the way up. And for argument's sake, if we turn the attack control all the way down, we get this on the same pickup, which is a slightly more muted and muffled sound. This will become more apparent as we play with the pedal. So if I turn the pedal on and we keep it kind of a medium hot gain sound, we'll get the voice control in the middle. Here's the attack control off. Perhaps a little muffled. We'll turn the attack control up to simulate a very spiky, very bright amp. Perhaps a little harsh. Now, what you can do in this situation, if you're touring or you're using a rented backline, you can use the voice control to tailor this pedal to the sound of your amp. So if we go with the idea of having this very bright amp, perhaps like a Fender Twin almost, or a Vox AC30, a very bright, very forward sounding amp, you can back down that voice control to kind of tame the pedal a little bit. Perhaps a little too far, we'll go there. And likewise, if you end up with a very muffled sounding amp, let's turn the attack control all the way down and I'll turn the volume up a little to compensate. You might be able to go from this sound, which is a little muffly, up to something more like this. Or even all the way up, we get something like this. So it's a really useful control and it affects both sides of the pedal equally. It's really there, like I say, to tailor the pedal to the amplifier that you're using, but if perhaps you're shooting for a particular sound, if you're playing something that requires a lot of high-end articulation, you can just bump that voice control up regardless of the amp you're using, or if you want a very smooth overall sound, you can pull it back. It's very, very powerful control. For the time being, we're gonna leave that just past 12 o'clock and I'll return the amp to where I had it. And let's do a final experiment with the three-band EQ. So we're gonna start off with the mid-range, because mid-range is very, very powerful. Let's turn it all the way down. So it gets really scoopy as we turn it up. Everything gets really rather honky. Let's set that back to the middle. Let's play with the bass control. We're gonna turn it all the way down. Turn it all the way up. So there's quite a lot of kind of cabinet-y, woofy low end available there. I would suggest you possibly want to use this again to tailor the low end of your different sounds to the amp you're using. Let's play with the treble. Treble all the way down. It's going to sound like. And as we turn it up, all the way up. It can get a little harsh, but a cool thing to do is if you turn the treble all the way up, you can back the voice control down and get a different kind of high end, which is a bit like this. Perhaps it's a little more compressed, but there's still quite a lot of high end presence. Whereas if we keep the voice control neutral and we turn the treble down, we get something a bit more like this. And then if we go even further, we turn the treble all the way off and we turn the voice control up, we get something like this. So just different flavors of the same thing. You can really tailor this to however you like. Now, one final thing I want to show you is how I've been using this pedal. Because over here, what we got is a Coco Boost Reloaded, also from Suhr Pedals. I've been using this as a mid boost to drive my lead channel that little bit harder. So I've set my pedal up with a rhythm sound that is pretty much everything on 12s. Depending on the amp I'm using, I'll use the voice control to kind of find that sweet spot. And then for my lead channel, I've rolled down the bass a little bit. We roll the mids up pretty high and we take the treble back. And I've also moved the volume, normally move the volume a little bit higher, but I'll keep it the same for today. And again, you know, that's just kind of like kind of my personal taste for how I like to use this pedal. We've got a low gain rhythm sound, sounds like this. Stick the boost on. And then if we do the same thing, our lead channel is this. Notice the gain's not set too high. But it's a much warmer, much honkier sound. It really carries in a mix if you stick the mid boost on top of that. All hell breaks loose and we get. And that's still with the coil tap engaged. If we pop the humbucker in, sounds like this. Thank you. So hopefully you can see from that that even though the pedal certainly has enough gain for pretty much any application you can think of, it does take boosts pretty well as well if you want to turn your setup from being a 3-channel amp into, say, a 6-channel amp if you're a bit of a tweaker like me. Now, one final cool thing about this, if I just tip these this way a little bit, you guys can see on the top, we have this little thing. I hope the camera can see that all right. If not, I'm sure we'll get a shot of it. That is the effects link, which allows you to operate the pedal remotely, i.e. you can operate the foot switches, so you can turn either channel on, you can switch between the channels and you can turn it off, which means if you're using a switcher, like a Gig Rig or like a Boss ES8, or you have these pedals in a rack drawer, you can operate them remotely, or if you're at the front of a slightly lairy stage, you can even have a tiny foot switch down there. Keep these guys on your pedal board at the back of the stage. You don't have to worry about a pint going over your expensive new pedals. Anyway, that's it for this review. My name's Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. Had a lot of fun playing these pedals for you. I hope to see you very soon.